हेलो, वेलकम टू न्यू यूनिट नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी. वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी. जस्ट इट इज इंट्रोडक्टरी वीडियो टू नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी. सो फर्स्ट वी विल से व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय नैनो. ओके, इन ग्रीक द नैनो मीन्स वेरी स्मॉल और ड्वार्फ. सो व्हाट इज द एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ नैनो? It is just we are reducing the power of 10. Okay. See, for example, if we consider the size or length, so unit of length is meter. So if we reduce the power of 10, it will become decimeter, centimeter, millimeter, micrometer, nanometer. Or if we increase the power of 10, it will become kilo, million, billion, trillion, etc. So just it is the factor whether we are reducing the power of 10 or we are increasing the power of 10, and we are adding these words to any unit, not necessarily the meter. So what is nano? It is 10 raised to minus 9. So this nano word we can add before any unit. See, for example, if I say nanosecond, it means 10 raised to minus 9 second. If I say nanovolt, it means 10 raised to minus 9 volt. Similarly, nanometer, it means 10 raised to minus 9 meter. Okay. Now, in nanotechnology, we study nanomaterial. So, which material we call nanomaterial? If the size of material is in nanoscale, it is called nanomaterial. Okay. So, if size is in nanoscale, it is nanomaterial. But it is very vague definition. Because as I say, nano word, this we can add before any unit. See, for example, I will give an example. So, this is the scale in my hand. Okay. Now, you know, this is the scale and the length of this scale is 30 centimeter. It is 30 centimeter. But anything can be expressed in nano, because nano is just 10 raised to minus 9. That's the only meaning of that. Okay. So, can I say that it is 30 into 10 raised to 7 nanometer. Okay. It is 30 into 10 raised to 7 nanometer. So, similarly, anything we can express in nanoscale. So, do we call this material as nanomaterial? Suppose we have this table, the length of this table I am having here is about 1 meter. So, we can say the length of my table is 10 raised to 9 nanometer. But we don't call this as a nanomaterial. So, which material we call nano? So, we must have the specific definition for that. Okay. So, what is the specific definition of nanomaterial? If the size of material is reduced to nanoscale, it means it is between or less than 100 nanometer, then only we call this material as nanomaterial. Okay. If the size is less than 100 nanometer, then only we call it as a nanomaterial. So, it is just few atoms wide. Okay, if we take any material with this dimension 100 nanometer, only few atoms will be there in that material. Now, we know any material, any physical object, it has a three dimensions: length, breadth and width. So, if any one dimension is reduced to nanoscale, it is called quantum well. If the two dimensions are reduced to nanoscale, it is called quantum wire. And if all the three dimensions are reduced to nanoscale, it is called quantum dot. Okay, see this picture. So, this is the bulk material. It means it is bigger size material. So, you can see all the three dimensions. Here, we reduce this dimension. Width we reduce to nanoscale. So we get the structure that is planar structure, or we get two-dimensional structure. It has only two dimensions because one dimension is reduced to very small size nanoscale. It is quantum well. Now here, two dimensions, this dimension and this dimension, width and this breadth or thickness is reduced to nanoscale. So we get only one dimensional structure, or it has only length. So it is called quantum wire. And here all the three dimensions are reduced to nanoscale. So we get just a dot. So it is called quantum dot. Now why do we use the word quantum? Because when we study nanomaterial, its properties and applications, we have to use quantum mechanical laws, and so we use the word quantum. So this is quantum well, this is quantum wire, and this is quantum dot. Got it? See, what we are doing here in nanomaterial, we are just reducing the size of material to nanoscale, that is less than 100 nanometer. Okay, see, we are not applying using any physical or chemical process. We are only reducing the size. So what makes the difference to the nanomaterial? Why are we much more interested in nanomaterial? Because we are not doing any chemical reaction. We are not applying any physical process like increasing the pressure, increasing electric magnet, nothing we are doing. We are only reducing the size, but still we are more interested in nano. It is because when we reduce the size to nanoscale, it shows very different properties. See, for example, we know normally the allotropes of carbon, those are graphite and diamond. But if we reduce to nanoscale, we get carbon nanotube, and it is much stronger than steel. One more example I will give you. If we take the particles of gold, nanoparticles of the gold, its color is not yellow. There is change in color of gold nanoparticle. Similarly, we know plastic is insulator, but plastic nanotubes are many times conducting in nature. So there is drastic change in properties when we reduce the size of the material to nanoscale. And since there is change in properties, we have applications also in almost all fields of life, and hence we are interested in nanotechnology. Okay, now why there is change in properties of a material? Now we know the properties depend on arrangement of atoms. So at nanoscale, we get opportunity to change the arrangement of atoms, or we get opportunity to manipulate the arrangement of atoms, and therefore there is change in properties. This is the one point. Secondly, there is change in energy band structure, and so change in electrical and optical properties of a nanomaterial, and then there is change in surface to volume ratio, and hence there is drastic change in properties of nanomaterials. Okay. So what is nanoscience and nanotechnology? What are the exact definitions of nanoscience and nanotechnology? Okay, so nanoscience, it is the study of synthesis, characterization and applications of nanomaterial. So here first we define nanomaterial, then we study how to synthesize the nanomaterial, then we study properties of nanomaterial and different applications of nanomaterial. So that comes under nanoscience. And nanotechnology, it refers to arrangement and processing of atoms. As I told you, we get opportunity to make the arrangement of atoms or manipulate the arrangement of atoms. So we are able to fabricate the new devices at nanoscale. So these are nano devices. So that comes under nanotechnology. Okay, so we refer to nanotechnology, nanoscience. It means study of synthesis, properties and applications of nanomaterial. And nanotechnology refers to nano devices, how to fabricate the nano devices using nanomaterial. So that have wide applications in every sector of life, that is nanotechnology. So this was just introduction to nanotechnology. Now, in next videos, one by one, we shall discuss production techniques, properties, applications, and how to study the nanomaterial, what tools we use to study the nanomaterials. So these points we shall discuss in the next videos. Okay, friends. Thank you.